The New England Patriots just got huge news, so I want to break that down here on Patriots Today by Chat Sports. I'm your host, Allie Barefoot, and this news could also possibly go with every other team in the NFL. We're going to be breaking down what the possible changes to the league that you love, could happen in the next few years. But before we hop into that major news that impacts every single Sunday moving forward, I have one Sunday that I want to ask you guys about. If you want us to go live for every single Sunday Patriots game, go on ahead and hit that sub button. But if you're tuning in tomorrow, which is the first preseason game, Panthers versus Patriots, go on ahead and subscribe if you're going to be joining in here for our live watch party to kick off Patriots preseason. All right, the Washington Post did tweet this out a few weeks ago saying, "The NFL Players Association has engaged in high-level discussions with the NFL about the potential implementation of an 18-game regular season," the NFLPA's executive director has said. "This would mean turning the 17-game season that we already know and love, even though they've already extended most recently from 16 games to 17 games, would increase by one more. Doesn't sound like a lot, but it could have a drastic impact on the New England Patriots." So let's go ahead and break down the official statement here. Lloyd Howell saying, "We've talked at a very, very, very high level superficially with a recognition about, yeah, this is something that we should be talking about. And we should really kick the tires and understand what else goes into that decision-making process. The simple fact of the matter is, when you have a growing enterprise and there are opportunities within that intervening period of time when progress could be made and you could tweak the existing CBA legal document, why wouldn't you want to do that? I call it bargaining. I call it amendments. I call it updates to what is now a living document called a CBA. Yeah, I want to be able to have our membership in a position to jump on it when we can, not wait until their playing days are done, and it's like you go through the cycle all over again." I'm just going to summarize this right now, why the NFL is thinking about making this an 18-game regular season. More games, more money. That means another TV slot. That means another TV partnership. That means with that new money coming in for no longer last week of the regular season, week 17, but now the 18th, means you give the players, you give the teams more money as well. Well, Roger Goodell, that's what I always think of. Roger Goodell addresses a potential 18-game schedule, private equity, and ownership at spring league meeting. So now that you've got Roger, you got Lloyd Howell, you got a bunch of people in the front office of the NFL talking about this, it's not going to happen this season. It may not happen next season. If this were to happen, this is a 2-3-4 year in the future, while there are still players in the league right now that can still have their prime football days ahead of them. This is going to be a very long process. So I don't want you guys taking from this video and expecting some alert tomorrow saying, "Hey, we tacked on another game in this upcoming season." But what does this mean for the players? How would they like it if they had to play 18 games instead of 17? Well, Joe Burrow, the fresh haircut Joe Burrow in Cincinnati, actually came up with this plan that would help players, help teams, to have a perfect 18-game NFL schedule solution. Because you have to think, there's one bye week and a 17-week period. And there's two preseason games, maybe even three preseason games for all NFL teams. So there's a lot of downtime before actually playing those 17 real games. And if Burrow's in, I'm in. I'm all for it if the players are all for it. But this is just one guy. There are other players that may think that 18th game is a little bit too much. You got to think of injuries. You got to think of practice. You have to think maybe we can get two bye weeks. Maybe we have more rest if we're putting in more time to be there on week 18. Let's talk about Trevor Lawrence for a second. Jacksonville Jaguars quarterback. It's a lot of games, so I think there has to be some give. There's a lot of games on the players, and it's already 17. That's a lot. When we went from 16 to 17, maybe if there are two bye weeks, I don't really know what the conversations are there, but it does sound like there are players now starting to put their opinion out there about possibly changing this schedule for the NFL in the future. I'm going to be breaking down my take on the 18-game schedule, but I also want to know, why does this matter to the New England Patriots? Maybe you take away some preseason games. Well, then you had the argument that they need those preseason games because that's when players who really don't get to shine on Sundays get to showcase to teams, hey, I need a spot. Hey, I'm worthy of a spot. So you can have that argument. You can have that two bye weeks won't be good for a fan, won't be good for ratings. There are a lot of ins and outs on this, but I know that if you guys have made it this far in the video, you're asking the same question that I am. How does this affect the New England Patriots? Well, now that you have the groundwork laid out for you that I just showed you, we're coming up next. I'm going to tell you why you as a Patriot fan should want to stick around for the news that's about to come. First things first, I got to give a quick shout out here to our sponsor, Game Time. This is where I go if I'm getting any tickets for anything. And I just want to share you in on this beautiful app because Game Time allows you in multiple different cities. If you guys want to go on ahead and download Game Time, create an account, all you have to do is use promo code CHATSPORTS, CHATSPORTS. That's going to get you $20 off your first time buying tickets while terms do apply. Obviously, you guys can go to Boston Red Sox game right there in your backyard. New England Patriots games are right around the corner. So one more time, if you guys want to get started on Game Time, all you have to do is download the app, create an account, use promo code CHATSPORTS, CHATSPORTS, and you're going to get $20 off your first time guaranteed while terms do apply. All right, why does this matter to the New England Patriots? Well, it has to do with money. Thankfully, the Patriots have a lot of money right now, but if you do add on another game, if you do add on more broadcasting rights and you bring in more fans at Gillette Stadium, well, here are three reasons why it's going to help the New England Patriots. You will have more cap space to spend on players. For an organization that is currently rebuilding, this is music to my ears because we already know the Patriots have a ton of cap space right now. If not first in the league, then damn near second. But moving forward, what does your cap space look like in 2025, 26, 27? Well, they're going to rank second in 25 in the NFL when it comes to cap space. But then they move all the way down to ninth in 2026. Still fine, still top 10. Then they go down even further to the 16th highest cap space at $226 million in 2027. Why? Because a lot of teams are shedding their salaries. A lot of teams' contracts will be over, so their cap space is going to go up. But if I'm Elliot Wolf and I'm seeing the cap space we currently have right now, if you can get more cap space with an 18-game schedule, that is going to allow Elliot Wolf to not only pay the players he currently has on the roster, but go out and grab more players to make sure we bring Super Bowls back to New England where they belong. So before I hop into the other two reasons, here's a quick question for you. Do you guys like an 18-game regular NFL season? Let me know in the comment section down below. Type Y for yes, type N for no. Let me know what you guys are thinking while I tell you about the second reason why the Patriots need an 18-game season. Let's look at a player like Drake May, right? The face of your franchise, or that's who you want him to be, that's why you drafted him, with your first pick in the 2024 NFL draft. It's not every day NFL teams get a starting quarterback in the draft. Well, now you have Drake May, who is supposed to be him. He's supposed to be phenomenal. That's why he signed a $36 million rookie contract for the next 4 years. But because he has a first-round draft pick, he has a fifth option, so we'll have to reconvene between 2028 and 29. Not to mention, he already has a signing bonus of $23.7 million. This is what Drake May is getting paid. This is why he's supposed to be legit. If Drake May turns out to be him, turns out to be your franchise quarterback, which it may not be this season, it may not be for the first couple of games because he's still learning, he's going to get pricey. And the thing that I have learned is that the highest paid quarterback, the highest paid wide receiver, is only has that title for a very short period of time before somebody becomes the next highest paid. Somebody becomes the next highest paid. Drake May is going to be pricey in 4 years if he turns out to be what he's supposed to be. That's where cap space comes in. Not to mention, he's not the only player on the team. Because you're rebuilding, there are several young talent on the Patriots' offense and defense that will need to be paid in the future. And I'm talking about a player like Keon White. I'm having this conversation with my brother yesterday, talking about Micah Parsons, a very young player for the Dallas Cowboys. Well, they got to pay Dak. They got to pay CD, and if they had to pay Micah Parsons, the Cowboys are going to have a pretty hefty salary. Well, I'm starting to think the Patriots could have something similar in Keon White if he continues to show his dominance in year two. They've already extended multiple players to the Patriots this last offseason, and they did this with the highest cap space in the NFL. How are they going to continue to give players money if they're 19th, 16th highest in NFL cap space? Look at all these players that they are now agreeing to contracts through 2027, through 2028. It's going to get pricey. If the Patriots are in a rebuild period, the one thing that I want, if I'm a GM and I'm trying to create a Super Bowl winning team, is more money. That is why 18 games could be huge for the New England Patriots. And I like it. I'm all for it. You give me an extra day of football, I will take it. I see the pros. I see the cons. But ultimately, if you give the Patriots one more game and that they do end up having a good rebuild year, and the next year they win seven games this year, they win 10 games next year, they start being playoff contenders once more, they can start competing with bigger teams who are paying out the ass for their team to compete, the Patriots can be up there with more in cap space, already in the top 20 for the next 3 years for the NFL, and they can start bringing big stars to their team because they just tried with Brandon Ayuk, offered him $30 million. It may not have been enough for Ayuk, but the fact that you can still offer that means you're contending. So we'll have to wait and see. But thankfully, if there are anything that happens with the NFL, I will let you guys know right now on Patriots Today by Chat Sports. All you guys have to do for the latest update on your favorite team is subscribe.